So in this episode, I'll be taking a look at a constant current, constant voltage programmable power supply that I picked up off eBay, and I've turned it into a rechargeable lithium ion powered portable lab power supply. So in this project, I've used a few familiar parts. I've used the Pololu power regulator. In this case, I've used the 12 to 24 volt version, so it takes a 12 volt input and gives you a 24 volt output. I've used a no-name brand three-cell lithium ion power charging module. So this particular one will charge a single cell, two cells, or three-cell lithium ion powered battery bank. And I'm using three 18650 batteries in order to be able to give me the 12 volts out for the project that I need. But this particular module can charge all three, so it can charge a 12 volt or equivalent battery. I'm also using a couple of switches, a couple of banana plug terminals, and the programmable power supply module that I spoke about. I'm also using a Toolpro ruggedized storage box, the ones that come with the foam padding, etc. And I've just made my project inside of that, giving me plenty of space to be able to store a multimeter and all of the attachments to the multimeter. Put a little bit of lighting in there, and realistically there's even enough room for some small tools or even a Raspberry Pi 3 and an LCD if you wanted to put that in there as well. Okay, so this programmable power supply module that I picked up off eBay is rather nice little unit. It has a backlit LED display. It does have an input voltage range of 6 to 55 volts, and obviously I'm not putting that into it, I'm putting about 24 volts in. 0 to 50 volts out, obviously it is a step down system, so you can only ever get out less than what you're putting in. So in my case, I'm putting in 24 volts, I can have from 0 to about 23 volts as a range, but that is perfectly fine as a portable lab power supply. And although there are a few different models available, my particular model has a 2 amp output range, and that works out reasonably well as well. I'm using 18650 batteries as my power supply. Each one of those is rated at 4 amps, but realistically it's going to be about 2. So I'm getting 3 18650 batteries wired in series, puts out around about 12 volts, and I'll be getting 2 amps, pretty much continuous, a tiny little bit of drop going through the Pololu power regulator. But as far as everything's concerned, I'll realistically be able to get very close to 2 amps output from my power supply module and upwards of 22 volts. The module itself is controlled by this knob at the front, which is also a push knob, in order to be able to cycle through the individual settings. So you don't just dial from 0 right through to the maximum voltage. You can in the right setting, but you can actually pick each individual column, so the tens of volts, the individual volts, in order to be able to select the exact voltage that you want before you actually turn the device on. Having turned the device on, you can also head straight back into those settings and use that knob and adjust the voltage accordingly. The back of the device, it does have a fan, so if it does get too hot and you're pushing out close to its 2 amp limit, the fan will kick in and keep the unit nice and cool. This particular module also has a memory function, so you can preset some of the more desirable or your most used voltage ranges and recall those from the memory. So as you can see, there is a very slight variance coming out of the module as read by this multimeter. The multimeter is not one of the high-end multimeters, but it's reasonably accurate. So that very, very small percentage difference that you're seeing on the LCD of the power module and the display of the multimeter is well within tolerance for what my needs will actually be. I would be interested to test it with a few more multimeters, and I've only got two here in the lab at the moment. So I might do that a little bit later on and just see how accurate the display on this power supply actually is. The recharge module itself, and I'll put a link in the description of the video to that one, as I said, is able to charge a three cell battery bank, which is what we're getting here at the moment, which we're using in this device, three batteries in series. At the three cell option, which is selected by soldering these little jumper pads on the actual recharge module itself. So a single pad select, so two pads bridged is a single cell selection. Both series of pads bridged is a double cell selection. And in my case, no pads bridged is the 3-cell selection. So that's giving you a 12 to 12.8 output range. The module accepts anywhere from 14 through to 20 volts in this configuration in order to be able to charge the 3 cells. And it is capable of a 2-amp output, but when you're charging all 3 cells, so you're asking, like I said, around 12.8 volts coming from the module going to the battery bank, in that configuration, it'll only put out a single amp. But that's still reasonably good. So in this configuration, between 2 and 3 amps total capacity, it'll charge that battery bank in about 3 hours from completely flat. So that's a quick look around my portable rechargeable lab power supply and additional parts for testing purposes. I hope you enjoyed that. By all means, give it a thumbs up if you did, and please feel free to subscribe, and I hope you'll join me again in a couple of weeks' time.